I just want to start, not necessarily on a sour note, but I want to just make sure that we keep the people of Pittsburgh in thoughts and prayers as we celebrate a World Series last night. The city's going through mourning, so just want to, for all the people watching today, just make sure you get a special little prayer for people of Pittsburgh. I want to congratulate Alex Cora and the Boston Red Sox and the entire organization for an incredible run, 119 wins from start to finish. And I didn't realize the last night that they had won the spring training league and won the regular league, and then they won, obviously, the World Series last night. So it's exciting here in the city of Boston. I want to congratulate Red Sox Nation for our ninth World Championship here in Boston. This is an all-time great team we had. I think a lot of people enjoyed watching this team. Everybody contributed. I was talking to people, talking on the way into work this morning and thinking about everybody in the whole team. Everyone had a special play in this World Series. So congratulations to the entire team for your resilience and your positivity and the way you carried yourself on the field and off the field. And even last night during the interview session, thank you to all the players for the great work they did. These players are role models and we want to celebrate them in Boston style. Championship Duckboat Parade will take place on Wednesday, starting at 11 o'clock on Boylston Street by Fenway Park. It will continue down Boylston all the way to Boston Common, where they'll take a left on Tremont Street. It'll continue up Tremont to Cambridge and end at Stanford Street. And to be clear, there will be no rally at City Hall Plaza. This is just the parade that we're going to be doing on Wednesday. I'm excited as mayor to host my first Red Sox parade. I was getting used to the Patriots parades, and now we have a Red Sox parade, so I'm happy about that. And we have some great experiences here in our city, but we're not taking anything for granted. We hope to see a big crowd out there, but we do have a few messages out there. Do not try to drive to the parade. Take public transportation. Chief Green Community Police is going to get up here in a moment and speak, so we're encouraging everyone to take public transportation when you come in town. The MTA is going to be putting on extra service, and again, I'll let the chief talk about that. There'll be traffic and parking restrictions surrounding the route. This morning, we're working on a webpage. It'll be up in a little bit. It'll be boston.gov/Red Sox Parade. boston.gov/Red Sox Parade. I don't think it's up yet, but it's up. So it's up right now. So anyone who wants the details, please go to that website. As far as safety goes, I'm encouraging people, don't do anything on the streets of Boston on Wednesday morning that you wouldn't do in front of your own house. Be respectful of the city. Be respectful of the property. Be respectful of the people. Be respectful of the businesses. Be respectful of the Red Sox. When you come into town, just come in to enjoy the parade. There's going to be probably a lot of kids in town as well. But we're going to be asking you to be respectful. The Boston Police and the partners will be out in numbers to make sure everything and everyone is safe and has a great time. During last night, we pretty much had a great celebration in the city of Boston. However, we did have one arrest, a destruction of property arrest. Other than that, we had a great night of celebration in the city of Boston. I want to thank the fans. I want to thank all the colleges. I want to thank Boston Police Department, all the first responders, for doing an incredible job making sure that people were safe last night after the Red Sox won the World Series and throughout the whole series. We had extra police out there making sure that the areas were safe during the World Series and during the playoffs. So, again, I want to thank all our first responders and our police department for the great work they did. Boston has certainly set a new tone around celebrations, and maybe it's because we have a lot of them, or maybe it's because of the way that we conduct ourselves. So again, I want to thank you all. We are a city of champions, so let's celebrate like champions. And I'm going to turn the microphone over to Commissioner Ross, and then we're going to turn it over to Chief Green, and then I'll open up for any questions that people might have.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good morning, everyone. Well, congratulations not only to the Red Sox, but the city of Boston. For the most part, thousands of people celebrated peacefully, except for one individual that the mayor just mentioned, or question we said. Now it's time to celebrate, but as we've said during the entire series, we've been here before. Let's act like it. So we would ask everyone to act responsibly and be respectful of the other revelers in the parade. Also, we will have full coverage in our neighborhood. But for those attending the parade, no public drinking. Alcohol will not be tolerated. And you should know this, this should be common sense, but no weapons at all either. So we fully expect to have have a great parade, and I can go over the route for you again if you'd like. Again, the parade starts at 11. It'll be starting from Fenway Park. We'll start at Fenway, we'll go to Lansdowne, take a right on Ipswich Street, a left on Boylston Street, and then we'll follow Boylston Street, left on Tremont, the wrong way. And we'll follow it straight onto Cambridge to Staniford Street, where the parade will end. Again, it's time to celebrate. But I'd be remiss if I didn't say thank you to our entire first responder family, law enforcement, the fire, to EMS, to make sure that our series was safe and that everyone was protected in the city. As well, several outside agencies also assisted from their law enforcement councils. So again, let's celebrate responsibly. So now I'll turn it over to Chief Green.
Thank you, Commissioner. You know, this doesn't get old. I mean, I think this is my 11th championship in the last, 16 years? It just doesn't get old. That being said, the Transit Police are well experienced and prepared for special events such as Wednesday's parade. We encourage everyone, as the mayor says, to come into the city of Boston utilizing the MBTA transit system. We will have increased coverage, both uniform and in plain clothes, throughout the system to ensure it's safe and travel by all. We ask our riders to be respectful to one another and especially mindful of those with young children, the elderly, and people with disabilities as you utilize the MBTA transit system. And as the commissioner stated, alcohol consumption and or unruly behavior will not be tolerated at all on the MBTA. Currently, I mean, we got updates from the BRIC. There are no incredible threats to this event. With that being said, we also ask our riders to please, if you see something, say something. Nothing's too small. We need you to be our extra eyes out there. Contact us immediately, and we will send an officer out to investigate. With your help, we can have a safe and an enjoyable celebration. Now, as far as service with the MBTA, we will have additional slash extra services on all branches to include the commuter rail. There will be updates with that forthcoming. Thank you.
Any questions?
Why no rail?
Because the Red Sox have always historically done something at the front of the park with people, and then it comes in town. The Patriots have always done it in the rally outside here. I can't remember what the Bruins did or the Celtics, but we'll have to wait and see what happens in the next year or so.
And can you talk about the fact that it's Halloween as well? You mentioned
Yeah, it's tough timing, but unfortunately, like the Patriots, a lot of it is contractual. I mean, the players have certain times, and you know, if they had won the World Series in the Game 7, we probably could have pushed it to Saturday, but we got it done in 5. So it is about making sure you maximize the amount of people being here as well, the amount of players being here. So unfortunately, it's just the way it falls. I think the only parade that's falling on Saturday is with the Bruins in 2011. Every time it just seems like it's also contractual.
How do you people expect it based on past rallies?
It's hard to say.
We've had estimates of up to 1 million people that are coming down for the parade. Can we get 1 million people here? It's going to be a beautiful day out. I certainly wouldn't dispute those numbers.
And people, as far as arrival time, any time they can ride, or is you prefer a time frame?
They should probably come in earlier. We're going to shut the streets down in the morning.
So, the parking restrictions will be in place starting at 12 a.m. on Tuesday going into Wednesday. So that'll be posted. It'll be posted on bpdnews.com as well. So let everyone know that along the route that I just stated, there will be parking restrictions, and we will start towing at 12 a.m. So all of those streets should be shut down so we can take advantage of a clear route.
Commissioner, any rules for customs for parade goers, and any indication that any of the Red Sox would be wearing customs during the parade?
Well, it is Halloween, you know. I'm glad I don't have a face for radio, and I'll just stay as I am. But they probably will, who knows? But if you're in costume, we just ask you to act respectfully. And please, no costumes with replica firearms. Won't be tolerated. It shouldn't be on the route. We won't agree with costumes that have replica firearms because it just doesn't bode well for the festive atmosphere that we expect to enjoy.
Commissioner, can you talk a little bit about just how you guys, you mentioned the one arrest last night, it was a relatively safe night, but back in 2004, which was obviously a special year, was it more difficult crowd to control? How did you guys?
I have to honestly say, we've been stating it all week, we've been here before, and thousands of people, except for one individual, didn't get the message. I mean, we actually had people, for the most part, stay on the sidewalks and not block the roadways unless they were crossing the streets. They acted very well when they were in the area of the common. No one was disrespectful to the officers. A lot of high fives, a lot of celebratory congrats. That was it, just one individual. And that's exactly what we're looking for. Act like you have some sense.
You know, in light of what happened in Pittsburgh and we have big events like this, how challenging is it? And it is a concern, obviously, with that many people, a million people, like you said, in light of what happened in Pittsburgh, something to go wrong.
Well, thank God for the experience of everyone you see up here. Unfortunately, we've been through terrible tragedies before, but that just made us stronger in preparation for major events. So we often have tabletop exercises or reality-based training so that when something does happen, we're all communicating using the same tactics, and then together, along with just what Chief Green said, also utilizing the public to be our eyes and ears. So unfortunately, tragedies make sure that we're well prepared.
Are there any new security measures that you're taking? I know for a time, the major concern was people who drive a vehicle into a crowd. I mean, is there anything new that you're looking at?
So the past security measures that we've taken work very well, so we fully expect to implement them as well. And again, the best security possible is the thousands and thousands of pairs of eyes that are of our community. That's what we're talking about, community policing. Help us police this event.
Commissioner, are there any extra challenges with it being a holiday? Not just people being in costume, maybe, but other events going around the city, certain streets being closed for trick-or-treat and we can have an evening.
Well, the parade will happen in the morning into the afternoon. Then we'll transition into the festivity Halloween night. As usual, we prepare for that as well. And again, just ask everyone to act responsibly. You have a lot of little children out at night, grandparents, parents. Let's just act responsibly. And again, I hate to see replica firearms. Shouldn't even be in the household or part of the costume at all. It just makes for a feeling of uneasiness when you see that. But let's have fun on Halloween night. Dress up as the mayor.
Commissioner, are you all feeling a strain on your resources after the recent shootings and now this celebration? I mean, you've got a lot of officers on the streets. Are you feeling it in your organization?
Well, so these aren't regular shifts for us. So to provide additional resources, you cancel days off unless you have a scheduled vacation. It's called what we call a full call out. And we do that 3 or 4 times a year to make sure that everyone knows we have coverage in our districts where people live and a coverage for the venue. So there's no strain. Well planned for.
Commissioner, an expectation on how long the parade will last once it starts at 11, how long it will go to?
2 hours. We're hoping 2 hours. We don't want anyone jumping off the duck boats. So we're going to keep everybody on the boats in 2 hours.
Can you do one last question, everyone?
Let me just say this. Anyone who's dressed up tomorrow, be respectful. And whoever you dress up as, character, don't think you're in character. Don't think you're climbing poles, things like that. And also, if you come in early, I suggest you come in probably around 8 o'clock. Remember that people are trying to get to work as well that time, so be responsible and act responsible. Celebrate this team. I mean, this team, this team. seem, they play the character all year long, and celebrate the character in Boston, and go Red Sox.
Thank you.